Welcome to Pulpy Tamarind Channel. Today we will see how to make soyabean chunks or nuggets and cabbage fry. For that we need about 5 onions, 1 tomato. Saute 2 onions and the tomato in oil. Blend it into a fine paste. Take 2 tablespoons of grated coconut, 2 to 3 green chilies, slit lengthwise, 2 sprigs of curry leaves, coriander leaves, turmeric powder, cumin seeds powder, fennel seeds powder, coriander powder, salt, red chili powder, shredded cabbage. Boil the soya chunks or nuggets in salted water or in chicken or mutton stock. Wait for the water or stock to evaporate or drain it. Keep a kadai on stove and let it become hot. Add 2 to 3 teaspoons of oil. Once the oil is hot, add 2 to 3 slit green chilies and the rest of the onions which have been diced finely. And saute till they are soft and done. You can add the curry leaves and the coriander leaves too. So now you can see the onions have been sauteed in oil and now we have this as the paste with onions and sauteed onions and tomato and the soya nuggets which have been boiled and kept and the shredded cabbage. So we'll add one by one and make the fry. So now we'll saute the onions and at this stage you can add ginger garlic paste if you require. While boiling the soya nuggets, you can add in water, you can add a bit of turmeric powder and chili powder so that the smell of the soya nuggets disappears. But if you are adding chicken stock, it's okay. So now we'll add dry powders. So we are adding red chili powder, 1.5 tablespoon to 2 tablespoon as per your taste, turmeric powder, 1/4 teaspoon, and coriander powder, 1 tablespoon. And salt 1/2 teaspoon now, and then we'll add some more when we add cabbages and the chunks of soya, and also soya is being already cooked in salt water, so that we should keep in mind. I will add cumin seeds powder 1/2 teaspoon to 1 teaspoon and fennel seeds powder 1/2 teaspoon to 1 teaspoon as is required and as is the quantity made accordingly. So all the powders we added, let's saute it till the raw smell disappears and the onion and tomato which has been sauteed and grinded into a paste, we'll add that and then we'll add the coconut, grated coconut, which with the help of water we are going to make into a paste. So these two pastes will add and make the masala. So now we'll add the onion and tomato paste which was made after onions and tomatoes were sauteed in oil for some time. So that paste we'll add here. And we'll add the coconut paste. So that coconut paste is made with the grated coconut and the water. So both the pastes will add and mix into the masala and let it cook some time because we need the raw smell to disappear. Anyway, it's sauteed onions and tomatoes, but still it has to mingle with the rest of the masala and cook. So we need to wait for that. And once we are sure about this, we can go ahead and add the shredded cabbage. So now that the masala is cooked well, we'll add the shredded cabbage. So we are going to cut the cabbage in lengthwise and thin strips, as thin as is possible. And we'll wash and clean it and drain it and keep it. And that cabbage we'll add now. And we'll mix it with the masala. And after some time we'll add a bit of salt which is required for the cabbage. So we'll cover and cook at this stage and we'll wait for the cabbage to cook well. Once the cabbage is cooked and the masala is all mixed, the next part is to add the soya chunks. So we already added the coconut paste and the onion and tomato paste, so that everything is done. So if coconut paste is not added, we'll add it now. It's okay. Before soya chunks, we have to make the masala ready. So the step can interchange, no problem. So we need to cook. So we'll cover and cook for around 5 to 7 minutes. So now we are adding the coconut paste after the cabbage has been added. It's okay, you can add it before or after, it doesn't matter. So we'll add that, and then we need to wait for that to cook as well. So we need to give some time for that to cook. So let's mix it. So now everything is mixed well. So we'll add the required amount of salt for the cabbage at this stage and cover and cook for 5 to 7 minutes, as I said earlier. And then we will see how it's cooked, and then add the soya chunks. So the cabbage is cooked really well. So these are soya nuggets or chunks cooked. So now we will add the soya chunks or nuggets, which have been drained of salt water. And otherwise, there are two ways of boiling them. Either you boil this in salt water or in the stock, and wait for the salt water or the stock to totally evaporate. That's one way. Otherwise, you need to, once it's done, you need to remove it from the salt water or the stock, and squeeze and remove the excess salt water or stock and drain it completely before adding to the vegetable or the masala. So that way we ensure that there's not much salt. So there should be no overdose of salt. So that's the reason we need to do this. So we need to taste the masala here, and then if required, add some more salt. If we think the salt is enough, no need to add salt. So we already added some for the onions, some for the cabbage, and some already for boiling the soya chunks. So we need to be very careful. We can add oil here because we need to make a fry. So it is now nearly fried. Soya chunks with cabbage fry is ready. So it's now totally fried. We'll now change it into a serving bowl. Try to make soya chunks with cabbage fry. Soya chunks taste just like mutton. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you for watching Pulpy Tamarind Channel till now.